In this video, we'll learn how to edit color groups in Illustrator. I've got the file editcolorgroupdemo.ai open from this week's demo files. And here, I've spent some time coloring my artwork using a color group that I generated with harmony rules in the color guide panel. Color groups are the folders of colors that we see in our swatches panel. I'll click on swatches to bring that up. And here I'll find default color groups, such as grayscales, as well as ones I've made myself, like these three at the bottom that I made using the color guide. Of course, we can also manually make our own by making a new group and moving in individual swatches into it. So of course, we can edit any one of the swatches in a group individually just by double-clicking and making adjustments to the color. I'll click cancel for now. And sometimes it's exactly what we want, but other times we want to edit the colors in a color group while preserving or enhancing the relationships between the swatches in that group. In this case, we can use the Edit Color dialog just by double-clicking on any one of the color group folders in our swatches panel. This brings up the Edit Color dialog, and here I'll see the current color group as well as the current base color in the top left corner. Next to that, I've got a dropdown for different harmony rules, just like I had in the color guide panel. So I could bring in different sets of relationships based on the base color that I have selected right now. To the right, I also see the name for the current color group. And in this column on the far right, I'll see all of the color groups that I have in the current file. This matches what I see in the swatches panel. On the left-hand side, I've got controls for editing the current group. I'll see the color wheel, which shows me how the colors in my group are related to one another. Each small circle on the wheel represents one of the colors in my group. I can see that this color is the active color because its circle is bolded, and that's what I also see in my color picker below, as well as my base color above. By default, the wheel controls the hue and the saturation. One way I can make changes to my group is by clicking and dragging and moving all four colors around the wheel. Notice how I'm shifting all four individual hues while keeping the relationship between them the same. As I drag in towards the center, my colors get less saturated. I've also got controls below the color wheel that allow me to make the same changes. So you can see as I drag the hue slider, all four colors rotate around the color wheel. I can also set saturation or brightness for all the colors in my group. Now, if I wanted to make changes to this group, I could add or remove colors using the two icons just below and to the right of the color wheel. I could also unlink the group, which would allow me to make changes to individual colors, leaving the rest in the group the same. So I'll go ahead and make a few of those changes here. Now I'd like to save out the edits to my color group. So I'll give them a name and then click on the folder icon to create a new group. Now, while I'm here, I can also jump to any of the other existing color groups. And if I'd like to make changes to those, I could do so and then click the save icon. Once I'm done, I can hit OK. And I'll see the changes that I've made to my color group in my swatches panel. Okay, that's how to edit color groups in Illustrator.